gather in our time of joys and concerns, I want to point out that the response to "Hear us, O God" is, "Your mercy is great." It's in your bulletin. So we pray now in Jesus' name for the church, the world, and for all who are in need, saying, "Hear us, O God, your mercy is great." Holy God of healing and peace, we thank you for life and health, for morning and evening, for rain and sun, for all you give us to sustain life, and most of all for Jesus, who died and rose again to make real the promise of new life. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We ask, O God, for a church that ministers every day to bring people together in your name, for hearts that will not judge, for minds that recognize injustice and oppression in all its forms, and for the hands that are open to answer your call. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Merciful God, the nations you have called into being are many and full of marvels. We pray for their well-being, for the leaders and workers, teachers and soldiers, scholars, artists, parents, and peacemakers. For nations and peoples in strife, particularly the Ukraine and the Philippines, that your way be known in all the lands, and joy may reign. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Turn our hearts, Holy One, to respect and honor those who are not like us. Let us see in peoples of every nation the majesty of your desire for richness and difference. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for bodies and spirits healed, for those who are in pain, those awaiting surgery, for those who are struggling with physical therapies, for those awaiting death, for those carrying concerns, and for those we now name aloud and silently. For Candy's parents, who were both diagnosed with COVID. For the friends and family of Jane Jukes, a dear member of this church, Jocelyn Jones's mother, who passed away on Monday. Her grace and humor will be deeply missed. For the people of Afghanistan, for the thousands lost in the earthquake and the many thousands more whose lives will need to be rebuilt. For the people of Ukraine still fighting a war as the world's attention drifts away. Are there other concerns to lift up this day? For Ken, Amy's brother-in-law, who was in a car accident, whose car's last act was to keep Ken safe.
For a customer of ours who's having surgery.
For one of George and Amy's customers who's having surgery this week for breast cancer.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for those lifted up with joy, for John Panto's daughter, for John and Anne at their wedding today, for worshiping with the people we haven't seen in so long and have missed so much. Are there other joys to lift up this day? A 97, 94, I can't even do the math, there's so many numbers there. That's like 300 years of love all in one place, of siblings brought together. I'm so glad. And what an amount of work for everyone to make that happen. So, for those joys. For a good splash. Son started Nashua at the Nashua Fire Department.
Yeah, he's been my parents are with him, and
doing something he cares about and matters to all of us so, so much. And for the son graduating from high school, two huge milestones in 1 year. Congratulations. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We ask your special blessing, O God, on the children in our communities for their play and work in this summertime, to give them strength and renewal for an ever-increasing opening of the minds, new ways of seeing, new understandings of the gifts you call them to use, and for their happiness and health. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For the secret burdens we lift before you now, either silently or aloud. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We give you thanks for the saints who have taught us how to listen to your word, how to answer your desire for our lives, and how to teach and proclaim your love to others. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Into your hands we place our prayers and all those whose welfare we entrust to your care. Bless them and all who have needs that only you can know. In thanksgiving for all your gifts, we pray this in the name of the one God, Mother of us all. Amen. Let's recite the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power